Madhulika Kumar. She has completed her Master of Architecture in Architectural Association, London, UK. She then went on to work at Shanmugam Associates and integrated design on projects ranging from residences to regional planning, sustainable master planning, water calculation, etc. She was also known for her master thesis, which was selected for public display at AA, which was also selected for summer exhibition and shortlisted to publish at a national conference in UK.
Welcome to UGC lecture series for BE Architecture. Today's topic is Climate and Built Environment, Unit 1, Climate and Human Comfort, subject code AR6303. Presentation outline. The presentation has been divided into three main categories. First, introduction, and then about climate study, and then we move on to human body and heat balance. So, let's have a look at climate and weather. So, what is the difference between climate and what is weather? So, what is climate? It has been said that climate is what you expect, weather is what you get. So, climate is prolonged for a longer duration, whereas weather is according to day-to-day variations. The climate of an area or a country is known through the average weather along a long period of time. If an area has more dry days throughout the year than wet days, it could be described as dry climate. A place which has more cold days than hot days could make it known as to have a cold climate. Some of the factors which determine climate are the climate, the factors of sun, sky condition and weather, humidity levels and topography and all these factors contribute to deciding the climate of your location. So, if you are living in a country like India, it has mixture of different climatic classifications. When you consider places like southern India, we predominantly have longer, hotter days and which has higher level of humidity. So, we classify ourselves as warm and humid or hot and humid climatic region. But whereas when you move to places like northern India, it has places like Himachal Pradesh or Shimla or Leh Ladakh, in which colder days are much more prolonged. So, those regions are classified into colder regions or colder climatic conditions. So, what is weather? Weather describes the condition of the atmosphere over a short time of period. Example, from day to day or week to week, while climate describes average condition over a longer period of time. So, this is the major difference is climate describes to longer duration of what we expect and weather is the day to day variations that we see on every day. So, even during a summer month, few days might be rainy. So, that rainy days, it's due to the weather condition of the day, but overall when you look at the overall month or overall the period, it can be classified only as summer period. And humidity, air temperature and pressure, wind speed and direction, cloud cover and type, and the amount and the form of precipitation are all atmospheric characteristics of the momentary condition we call weather. So, it depends on lot of factors such as cloud condition, humidity levels, precipitation and amount of rainfall, wind direction, wind speed, etc. All this contribute to your day to day changes in weather, as well as overall this longer duration of the weather is being classified into climate. So, factors that determine the climate are elevation or altitude affects climate. So, in which means the location of your place in relevance to the sea level that is surrounded by you. So, higher the altitude, much colder temperature you usually experience. That is why we experience such kind of colder temperature in hilly regions. And prevailing global wind direction. So, the wind direction of your place as well as the wind speed and if it has 6 months, the wind direction is been changing. So, for example, in places like Tamil Nadu, we have two different major wind directions, northeast and southwest. So, it changes every 6 months. So, this is predominantly noticed in all tropical regions, the climatic direction, the wind direction to be changing for every 6 months. And topography of the place, if it's hilly or if it's flat topography. So, this determines according to the area you are located and also with relevance to the city in which your site is being located. And effects of geography, surface of the earth and climate change over time. So, all this other than the existing conditions of the site such as topography, climate, elevation of the site, etc., we also need to depend on climate change factors which we are facing every day, and the microclimate factors that that happens in your locality and the surrounding places, which contributes to major changes compared to the overall or global climatic factors or climatic range that we expect. So, this depends on where your zone of climate is being located. So, as you look at this picture, you can see lot of different various kinds of climatic locations, climatic classifications that been done for the entire globe, and then this is where we have our India, and we have lot of mixture of climatic conditions from hot and dry, warm and humid and cold regions, mixed climate, composite, monsoon climates, etc. So, you need to be conscious in which region your site is being located or which city you are designing for and what climate that region experiences. So, the climate depends on latitude which means this is the equator which is passing through the globe, and from which these lines which is being drawn are known as latitude lines. So, and then longitude, which are the vertical lines which are drawn, and the altitude, which means the elevation or height of the place, which in relevance to the surrounding sea mean level. And now moving on to tropical climates. A tropical climate is a kind of climate typically in the tropics, defined as non-arid climate in which all 12 months has mean temperature of above 64.4 degree Fahrenheit, which is equivalent to 18 degree Celsius. So, tropical climate is usually defined as the climatic condition in which there is no much of seasonal variation throughout the year. So, throughout the year it is usually warm and humid with high temperatures more than 18 degree Celsius, and even the humidity levels are higher throughout the year. And this usually is experienced from the equator 23.5 degrees above and below. So, as you see, this is our equator line, and 23.5 degrees north of the latitude, this line 23.5 degrees south from the equator, this forms Tropic of Capricorn. This line between whatever the climatic places which are located between these two lines experiences tropical climate, which is doesn't have much of a difference or seasonal variation throughout the year. And tropical climate can be divided into three major climatic zone and three subgroups. So, it's warm and humid equatorial climate, warm and humid island or trade wind climate, which is the subgroup of warm and humid equatorial climate, and then it is hot, dry, desert or semi desert climates. These are the climatic condition which we experience in arid regions or places like which has deserts, Rajasthan, Sahana and places like that, and it is subclassified into hot and dry maritime desert climate. And composite or monsoon climate, which is a combination of both warm and humid climate and hot and dry climate. So, in some of the regions you might experience during summer months, it might be very hot and dry because higher the temperature, the relative humidity that is present in the air is being evaporated, which makes the air very dry. During the monsoon seasons, due to the presence of continuous rainfall, the humidity levels present in the air is very high, which experiences warm and humid climate. So, when you experience both this combination of climates in one year, this is classified into composite or monsoon climates, which is subcategorized into tropical upland climate. So, let's look into classification. So, types of tropical climate has been divided into three major categories, which is warm and humid climate, hot, dry, desert climate, composite or monsoon climate. So, the subgroups are warm and humid climate is subdivided into warm and humid island climate, hot and dry desert climate subgroup is hot and dry maritime desert climate, composite or monsoon climate is tropical upland climate. Now, moving on, having a closer look at each of the major subcategories, first let's look at warm and humid climate. So, warm and humid climate found in a belt near the equator extending to about 15 degrees north and south, example Malaysia, Jharkhand, Singapore, Hawaii, US. So, from the equator, Tropic of Capricorn and Tropic of Cancer, which is located 23.5 degrees north and south, experienced the tropical climate, but under which from the equator 15 degrees north and the south experiences warm and humid climate. Some of the examples are Jharkhand, Malaysia and USA and Singapore, even parts of Tamil Nadu like Chennai, Coimbatore experiences typical warm and humid climate, which doesn't have much of a difference between winter seasons or summer seasons, and we experience throughout the air temperature is above 18 degrees Celsius throughout the year, and even the humidity levels are very high. So, as you see in this picture, these are some of the places which experience typical warm and humid climatic conditions. Let's have a closer look at climatic conditions. So, for warm and humid, the usually air temperature during the day is 27 degrees Celsius and it can go up to 32 degrees Celsius. At night, it fluctuates between 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. So, you might observe the diurnal variation from the day and the night is typically just between 6 to 5 degrees Celsius. This is because due to the presence of high cloud cover conditions during the night, which lets to trap the heat within the environment and doesn't make the heat release to the outer space. And humidity, relative humidity remains high 75% for most of the time, but vary from 55% to almost 100%. So, as we know, warm and humid climate also experiences high level of humidity. So, the relative humidity might vary from 55 degree to even it might go up to 100% throughout the year. And vapor pressure is between 2500 to 3500 nano per meter square. And precipitation, high precipitation, because we have extended period of monsoons, and the rainfall is also high during throughout the year, and summer also experiences few rainy days. High precipitation or rainfall throughout the year generally becoming more intense for several consecutive months. Annual rainfall 2000 to 5000 millimeter in 1 year, occurrence of gusty wind and electric storm. So, sky condition are fairly cloudy throughout the year, cloud cover is 60% to 90%. Because of the presence of high cloud cover, we do not have much of variation in air temperature during the day and the night. This is why we have very less diurnal variation. So, solar radiation normally high or maximum partly reflected and partly scattered by the clouds. Due to the presence of high cloud cover, we have high solar radiation occurring, but we have also a combination of reflected and refracted solar radiation due to the presence of high cloud cover. Higher sun and longer days is distinctly wettest as at Palembang, Indonesia, or the time of lower sun and shorter days may have more rain, that is for typical example is in Malaysia. So, solar radiation usually high, but even though we experience a lot of monsoon days as well. Wind velocities are typically low, calm periods, strong wind can occur during rainy squalls. So, during rainy days, we usually have higher wind speeds, which wind speed can typically vary from 4 to 6 meter per second, but during summer days or which is prolonged seasons, we usually experience very low wind conditions. Vegetation grows quickly due to the frequent rains and higher temperature, difficult to control, high humidity accelerates molds and algae growth, rusting and rotting. So, due to the presence of high humidity levels and high or extended monsoon days, we have good amount of vegetation. Sometimes it becomes very hard maintenance or control algae growth, etc. This is also a typical character of warm and humid climatic condition. So, now moving on to hot and dry desert conditions. Occur in two belts at altitude 15 degrees and 30 degrees north and south. So, it varies from altitude of 15 to 30 degrees from north and south from the equator line. So, examples that we can see usually the presence of deserts in India like Rajasthan, Saudi Arabia and South Africa are all typical examples of hot and dry climatic conditions. Air temperature during the day between 43 degree and 49 degrees Celsius. At night, cool seasons between 10 to 18 degrees Celsius, during dry seasons between 27 to 32 degrees Celsius. So, as we observe compared to warm and humid climatic condition, in hot and dry desert climates, we have good diurnal variation from morning to day. This is because of less cloud cover. So, humidity, relative humidity is low from 10% to almost 55%. So, because of high radiation levels and presence of less cloud cover, the moisture content present in the air usually gets evaporated easily. So, the relative humidity is very less. So, vapor pressure, it changes from 750 to 1500 nano per meter square. Precipitation slight and variable throughout the year, limited rainfall 50 mm rain in a few hours. Flash rain may occur, but some regions may not have any rain for several years. So, this depends on the place and climatic weather conditions of how much rain it's going to experience, because few days it may experience a lot of rain or extended rainy days, but overall it stays completely dry throughout the year. And sky condition are normally clear cloud or few due to low humidity of the air. During storms, skies are dark and dull. So, due to the presence of less cloud cover, we have good amount of diurnal variation from day to night. Solar radiation, strong and mainly direct during day. Absence of cloud permits easy release of heat stored during the night. So, using nocturnal radiation cooling or coupling day and the night cooling effect can be easily done, or it's much more effective in climatic conditions which experience good diurnal variation, which one of the typical example is hot and dry desert climates. Solar radiation, strong and mainly direct during the day. Absence of cloud permits easy release of the heat stored during the day. So, due to the presence of less cloud cover, the heat that is stored during the day can be easily released outside during the night because of lesser air temperatures. Wind, hot and together with dust and sand, occurrence of sandstorm. So, this is a typical example what we must have observed in hot and dry desert climate. Usually there is a dusty winds that it's been like a storm which usually comes during when there is higher amount of wind speeds. Vegetation, sparse and difficult to maintain due to lack of rain, low humidity. Examples are palm and cactus forms typical vegetation types that we usually observe in desert climates. Soil is usually dusty and very dry. This is due to the presence of higher winds and as well as lesser relative humidity. Composite or monsoon climate usually occur in large land masses near the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn, which are far from equator. So, composite or monsoon climates usually occur very close to 23.5 degrees towards the north and the south from the equator line. So, this comprises of New Delhi, Mandalay, Lahore or few examples of typical climatic regions which experience composite or monsoon. Two seasons, 2/3 of the year is hot and dry and 1/3 of the year is warm and humid. So, as we discussed earlier, it's a combination of both the climates of warm and humid and hot and dry, in which 2/3 of the year the climatic regions experience hot and dry seasons and 1/3 it experiences warm and humid. Localities further north and south often have a third season best described as cool dry. So, as we move above these 23.5 degrees towards the north and south from the equator line, say such as Jammu and Kashmir and places like closer to Russia, we might have observed there is one more season which is typically cool and dry season, in which the air temperature is very less and also the relative humidity is also very less. So, the different seasons that's been experienced in composite climates are classified under air temperature. So, season, hot and dry, warm and humid and cool and dry climate. So, during daytime, mean maximum can vary from 32 to 43 degrees Celsius, and during warm and humid season it might vary from 27 to 32 degrees Celsius, and during cool dry season it goes up to 27 degrees Celsius, and this is for the daytime. And during the night time, mean minimum temperature is 21 to 27 degrees Celsius. For warm and humid it is 24 to 27 degrees Celsius, and for cool and dry it can go as less as 4 to 10 degrees Celsius. And the diurnal mean range, which means the difference between the daytime maximum and nighttime minimum temperature, is 11 to 22 degrees Celsius, and warm and humid seasons it is 3 to 6 degrees Celsius. Cool and dry seasons it is 11 to 22 degrees Celsius. So, there is good diurnal variation during hot and dry seasons and cool and dry seasons, but when you observe warm and humid season, the diurnal variation is very less. So, you need to make design articulations according to seasonal variations as well. And humidity, relative humidity is low throughout the year, dry period at 20 to 55%, and wet season it rises to 55 to 95%. Precipitation, The monsoon rain are intense and prolonged during wet period. During dry season, little or no rain, heavy dew at night, hail and thunderstorm may also occur. So, this is a typical combination what we have seen earlier, warm and humid climate as well as hot and dry desert climates. And solar radiation, strong and direct during the clear period. So, it depends on the cloud cover which changes according to seasonal variation. And wind, variable, predominantly northeast, southeaster lies. So, the wind direction varies or changes according to seasonal variation. When it is warm and humid climatic condition, the wind direction is from one side, and when it is hot and dry desert climatic condition, the wind direction changes. Vegetation, green, although not very luxuriant during the wet season, but in the dry season when the ground can turn brown or red. So, depending on the climatic variations or seasonal variation, the ground cover or vegetation growth also changes according to the changes in air temperature and relative humidity levels. So, typically for composite or monsoon climates, the architectural elements that we need to follow is roof and external walls to be constructed in solid masonry or concrete, and resistant and insulation placed at outside surface of external walls and roof. So, we need resistant insulations to act according to the climatic changes that's been happening throughout the year. So, this insulation has to be placed outside to protect our interior from harsh climatic variations. Large opening in opposite walls, preferably with solid shutters. So, we need to have huge openings. During hot and dry seasons, we might want the wind to come inside, but during cold and dry seasons, we might want to cut down all the winds by having wooden shutters. So, these are some of the typical examples that we can see observed in architectural articulations that can be made for composite or monsoon climates. So, let us move on to the last part of the presentation, which is human body and heat balance. So, thermal regulatory system. So, this is how the thermal regulatory system works to maintain the human body in thermal comfort. So, the CNS is central neural system which is being connected to our body tissue, skin, clothing and environment. Depending on factors such as activity changes, environmental changes, clothing changes, posture, which are the actions that is going to arise here subject to warmth. If you are sitting, you might feel your activity level is very less, but when you are dancing or practicing a martial art, your activity pattern is very high, which means you are going to sweat more. And environmental controls, such as having control to your environments by presence of wooden shutters or closing and opening of windows or insulations, movable insulation panels, etc. And other activities which is involuntary actions which we do without our control to maintain our thermal comfort are shivering, sweating, vasco-regulation. So, when there is a cold wind that has been passing through us, when we are lesser than the thermal comfort, we usually shiver and we feel much colder. This is how skin reacts usually when we need to adjust to the thermal comfort. So, body tissue, the mechanism to keep body temperature constant at above 37 degrees Celsius. So, the skin temperature for a human body is 37 degrees Celsius. So, to maintain within that temperature range, so body usually reacts with shivering or vascular regulation or sweating to heat loss or to gain the heat from the surrounding environmental conditions. This is how the heat flows from body tissue to skin and to clothing and then to the environment, and these are the actions which is being formed by the body tissue and the skin. The information is passed on to the central nervous system, and central nervous system acts by involuntary actions such as shivering or sweating. These are again the factors and the physics which goes into maintaining the human thermal comfort or body tissue, skin, clothing and environment. And these are some of the physiological actions that we do, or shivering, vasco-regulation and sweating. And behavior is also essential component. So, posture, activity changes and environmental control and clothing changes. So, depending on for which type of activity that is going to take place in a environment, you need to change your design to meet up or maintain the human body in thermal comfort or to maintain human heat balance. All this depends on your central nervous system, or all these are controlled by your basic informations. So, heat exchange of the body with the environment happens by respiration, radiation, convection and evaporation. So typically examples of evaporation is when you sweat out, you might have observed our fingers or feet becomes much more wetter, acts quicker to the surrounding environment. So these are the active points of in which evaporation constantly happens to maintain the human body to heat balance and to maintain the skin temperature to 37 degrees Celsius. And by radiation, convection and respiration, these are activities which happen involuntary due to the central nervous system. The physics of heat loss. For the body to remain at a constant temperature, the metabolic heat produced must balance the heat losses by convection, which is air temperature, and air speed, which is present in the environment that is surrounding us, and radiation, that is surface temperatures. The surface in which we are in contact with is mean a surface temperature, which is very essential for places in which we are going to be constantly in touch with the surface or the ground. Evaporation, temperature, humidity, airspeed. So, when there is evaporative losses, it depends on temperature, humidity and airspeed. Conduction and controls. So, occupant can use controls offered by the buildings to change the environment to suit their needs. Window opening, fans, shading devices or such controls, they are available, but there are many constraints on their use, such as conflicts between occupant needs and accessibility, etc. So, you must have to provide controls in such a way, single occupant or 2-3 occupants can control each and every opening or windows or apertures depending on their need and depending on their body regulations to maintain each and every individual's human heat balance. So, some of the controls are having controls towards your windows and having controls to your even mechanical equipments. So, if there is a fixed glass window, there is no point of having it if the occupants cannot control it, open it or close it to control their daylighting and as well as natural ventilation levels. To summarize the overall presentation, so let's see what we have learned throughout this as learning outcomes. So, first we got introduced to what is climate and what is weather and factor that decides the climate of your place. Different types of climatic condition predominantly present in the tropics, human body, heat and heat loss, physics of heat loss in a human body. So, questions: what is the difference between climate and weather? What determines the climate of a place and decides the weather? Explain briefly about hot and humid climatic zone with example. What is the physics of heat loss? How does human regulatory system maintain thermal comfort? Thank you.